I am so excited to be partnering with Audible for this video. I am consistently impressed with Audible's spectacular array of audiobooks, podcasts, and Audible original titles spanning a wide variety of genres. Whether I'm in the mood for high fantasy, juicy romance, historical nonfiction, or perhaps a crime thriller, Audible has me covered for education and entertainment alike. For the autumn season, I've been loving listening to spooky titles while doing my makeup, cooking, and going for walks. My top favorite lately would have to be Coraline. It was an amazingly creepy, yet cozy listen that kept me on the edge of my seat the entire time. I was so inspired by Coraline's bravery and persistence, and loved the overall theme of the story, that bravery is not the lack of fear, but rather continuing on and achieving your goals despite your fear. As an Audible member, you get to pick one title a month to keep in your library from their entire catalog. Members also get access to a growing selection of fresh Audible original titles, making membership even more valuable and giving all members the opportunity to find new favorites and new formats, like the exclusive Words and Music series or podcasts. New members get to try Audible free for 30 days, so be sure to visit my link below, audible.com/goodnightmoon, or text goodnightmoon to 500-500 to start listening to a spooky title of your own today. Hello there. Who are you? Nice to meet you. I'm Coraline. Not Caroline. Coraline. Say it after me. Coraline. Good. Do you want an apple? I've got two in my pockets most of the time. I tend to get pretty hungry out on my expeditions. I don't think I'll be needing both today, however. I already had some tea and biscuits with my neighbors. Here, this one's all yours. So, do you live around here? Oh, really? What's your house like? Is it big? Mine's pretty big, but it's not just mine. It's separated out into pieces. Other people live upstairs and downstairs. Miss Spink and Miss Forcible used to be actresses. They live on the flat on the ground floor. It smells like dust and velvet in there. They've got a bunch of Highland Terriers. Have you seen them before? I think their names are Hamish, Andrew, and Jock. Yeah, you've probably seen them going for walks around the neighborhood. Hard to miss them. I love when Miss Spink takes dogs out in this weather because she gets so bundled up in layers and layers and layers of pullovers and cardigans. She looks like a big fluffy egg. And her glasses make her eyes look huge. I like your hair. Can I play with it? Thanks. She says it in this really insistent way, like I don't believe her. I believe her. They've got pictures from their glory days all over the walls of their place. She was quite a looker, I admit. Miss Spink had long, long legs. She wore these green tights with tall brown boots, the kind with lots and lots of laces. And Miss Forcible had a lacy white dress with flowers pinned in her pretty blonde hair. Now they're old. They make all right company. You should stop by there sometime for a tall, refreshing glass of limeade. Don't go expecting it to taste like lime, though. You'll be sorely disappointed. It tastes green. Bright green. When I drink it, special powers, like being able to talk with animals. We can share. There's an old tennis court, and that's kind of falling apart, but we could probably still play. It'd be easier with less net to get in the way. That's good, I'm not great at tennis. And the rose garden. Sometimes I get scared that there's just a bit of a delay and someday they'll come true at once. I think I've cast a height increasing spell at least 8 times by now, so if one of these days I wake up 30 feet tall, I'll have no one to blame but myself. Anyway, then there's the well. The well is the most interesting of all. All boarded up with these heavy wooden planks. I've tried to lift them, but these noodle arms don't get much done. There's a hole in one of the boards, though. It's fun to drop pebbles and acorns and stuff through. It's silent at first, but after a while, there's this satisfying plunk when they finally hit the water. Different Sometimes my dad comes exploring with me, though. When I was a little girl, a long, long, long time ago, we lived in our old house. He took me for a walk in the wasteland between our house and the shops. It wasn't the best place to go for a walk, really. It was kind of a junkyard. It was full of all these things. He said he hadn't been scared when he had been waiting down there with them, giving me the chance to run, because it was his only choice of going back again to get his glasses when he knew the wasps were there. Then he said he was scared. He was really scared. And he said that was brave, because when you're scared, but you still do it anyway, that's when you're really brave. Something like that. Anyway, what else can I tell you about? Well, there's a hedgehog I've seen around here. Have you seen a hedgehog before? Oh, he's cute. He's really round. I think he gets fed well. Maybe some of the neighbors leave food out for him. And there's the black cat. Yeah, he doesn't have a name. He likes to perch on walls and tree stumps, watch me explore. He was pretty standoffish at first, but I think we're friends now. I'd like to think so, at least. He goes for walks with me in the mist. I love hearing his little footsteps trotting along behind me, crunching leaves. He's light on his feet, but those crispy autumn leaves crunch for anything. Here, well, why don't you come meet him? Come this way. He likes when I pet him, so he'll probably be cool with you approaching, so long as he's getting pet. Oh, there he is. Do you see him? Lovely, silky black Anyway, that's the black cat. Maybe you can make friends with him too. Do you have any marbles? So you keep yours in this box. That's cool. I like the color of it. Looks like it could fit a good amount of marbles. Is it okay if I pour them out? Okay, thanks. I'll do it carefully. I don't want to lose any to the grass. Oh, wow. You've got a lot of pretty ones in your collection. Look, it's like little berries I gathered from the woods. Oh, I'm sorry. Don't want them getting mixed up. Let's see. I have these ones I think you might like. They kind of match your box, don't they? Sort of a similar color. So, let me grab one, two, three of those cherries. Would you be down to trade? What else have you got? Oh, this big blue one is awesome. I love the pattern inside. It's so detailed. Looks like the ocean. Okay, I've got this clear one with the red swirl. It's kind of Christmassy. Reminds me of peppermint. It's got these tiny bubbles in it. Would you want to trade these two? I like this clear one. It's the blue, red, yellow stripes running through it. What would you think of my aquamarine marble for that clear striped one? Perfect. And how about this dark blue one of yours with the white and orange spots in exchange for my perfectly crystal clear one? It's like a fortune teller's crystal ball. Cool. Wow, this dark blue one with the white swirl is incredible. It looks like frosting on a fancy pastry. Do you like my large aquamarine? It's a mermaid treasure. Can't you just imagine it tucked away in a mermaid's cavern with all her other shiny stuff? I'd like to trade it for your frosting marble, but if you like yours better, don't worry about it. Okay, neat. Here's your marble box back. Thanks for trading with me this one. I don't want to trade this one, but I just want to show you, okay? Mrs. Pink gave it to me. It was in a jar on her mantel place with a bunch of other little trinkets and old stuff. She said it's good for bad things, whatever that means. I do feel safer with it. feels cold. It feels smooth and comforting. It's like a lucky charm, I guess. I wonder what material it's made out of. Jade, maybe? Some sort of crystal. The swirls in it remind me of the marbles. And I can look at stuff through the hole. It's sort of like a magnifying glass. I guess not, because it doesn't make anything look any bigger or different at all. But I do think I notice more details when I'm not focusing on anything else except for what's appearing in that little circle. Like now your eye color all of a sudden is standing out to me more than ever. 'Cause I'm just focusing on your iris in the center of the hole and nothing else. And I bet if I look at your lips through when you talk, I'll understand you better. 'Cause I'm focusing on reading your lips. And maybe I could even count your freckles. That would take a while. Do you want to try? Here, let's find some stuff to look at together. You can hold it.
There's a cluster of clovers right. Of pink flowers in this tree. These petals look so flat and dry, like parchment paper. I bet fairies use these petals as paper for writing letters to each other. Or maybe as fabric for making clothes. I like the color of these leaves. Burgundy. They've got serrated edges, can you see that? Razor sharp little triangle edges. Those long, thin orange leaves are hovering around in thin air, levitating. Maybe they've had a spell cast on them. 1, 2, 3, 4 white flowers, shaped like trumpets. Imagine a band of snails, each playing one of these flowers. I wonder if they're going to carve these. What kind of faces would you do on them? I'd do a scary monster face on a big one, and a cute little kitten face on a little one with whiskers. Look at how the stem of the big one's got these curly, whirly vines spiraling around. And the top of the little one's stem is kind of shaped like a star, don't you think? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points. Perfect star. This tree has some gnarly looking sap. It's like the tree is bleeding. It really does look like blood red. But this part look how those ooey-gooey droplets have frozen in time in these drippy shapes. I wonder what the sap tastes like. Is it only maple syrup that's any good? Do you dare me to taste it? No? Okay, fine. This rose is a pleasant color, like butter. Butter rose. It'd make a good centerpiece for belongs to the neighbors though, so we'll leave it for now. Unless they cross us, then we'll pluck it. So, are you excited for Halloween? I still don't know what I'm gonna be. I can't decide if I wanna wear my witch costume, my ghost costume, or my scarecrow costume. That one might not fit me anymore though. The ghost we should go trick-or-treating together. I know all the best spots and the worst ones. Like, down that way, Mulberry Street. Best spot. It's full of old retired couples who hand out homemade treats. Freshly baked cookies. Caramel apples. You can't miss that green shingled house on the corner. You see the one with the two turrets and the yellow door. She has homemade Rice Krispie treats. Oh, they're still warm when they hit your basket. Yeah, you can thank me later. And then, avoid Chestnut Street. Scared or anything, mind you. Don't think I'm saying that. He wouldn't stand for that kind of defamation. He just sticks to places worth going to. And be warned that Miss Pink and Miss Forcible give out some pretty strange candy on Halloween. There's this caramel one, caramel walnut. I think it's called Walnetto. Sticks to your teeth like glue. Henry's are all right. Caramel, peanut, and chocolate. Basically a Snickers, but a little more sad. And no need to visit the old man upstairs on Halloween. He gives out, you guessed it, cheese. No thank you. I don't know where this black cat goes on Halloween. I always want to keep him close that night. Keep an eye on him, since I've heard that some sick weirdos like to be mean to black cats. What else did I bring in my bag? Oh. I was going to use these stickers as graffiti. Run around the neighborhood, sticking them on people's mailboxes and signs and posts and stuff. Do you want some? I can graffiti you a little bit. Let's see. I could put a little ghost right there on your cheek. Dinner should be ready about now.
I hope my dad didn't make a recipe.
Oh, it was nice to meet a fellow explorer. I hope we'll run into